a 10 by 20 cradle gesso board. Nothing super fancy. I took the liberty earlier. I painted all of the edges like with a brush to get the black on most of it. Obviously, I didn't do a super immaculate job in the middle. My hope is that I won't have to deal with the extreme tilting that sometimes can make you lose detail trying to get the color everywhere. I've seen several fluid artists do it. Molly's Artistry is a big one that likes to paint the edges before she starts. So I don't know if it'll help. It might. Hopefully. This is 24 inch base that it's on my spinner here. Got quite the rig set up. So I've got black pillow paint. I've got a series of fiery colors. I've got an interference gold. I've got a mixed up black that is not fully black. It's kind of like an off black with metallic. I've got a warm red. I've got a little bit of a very opaque orange. It's a cadmium orange. It's super opaque, so I have to be really careful with it. I've got a yellow, and I've got kind of like a butterscotchy caramel color that I made up custom. So those will be the colors that I'm using. I've got a red cell activator that is Liquitex Heavy Body Cadmium Red Deep, and I've got black cell activator that's Amsterdam Oxide Black, I think. I have Pandora Radio playing in the back with some oldies, because if my dog can hear people in the neighborhood doing regular neighborhood things, he will bark like the whole time I'm trying to be doing a video. All right, opening up all my little paint colors here, doing a quick stir to check how thick or thin they are. I love how some of them feel thicker, but they have a drizzle rate that's very similar, so. I'm sorry that y'all can't see all of what's going on over here. That's very thin. Why are you so thin? My caramel butterscotch color here is a little thinner than the rest of them, it seems. So I just added a little bit more of the ultra deep base to it. orange, then black, orange, then red, then the black, caramel, yellow, and I'm going to do interference gold. Okay, cool. If you hadn't noticed, today's going to be a swipe day. This is part of a quest for fire. Greek mythology, Prometheus stole fire from the gods and gave it to the humans, which was kind of frowned upon at the time, because humans weren't really anyone's favorite if you were a god. God, that's pretty. The bloom that I did last night had amazing fiery colors, but it didn't have enough of the black that makes you kind of believe that you're looking at fire. So, trying to add some more depth. Red. I'm hoping that using the red cell activator is going to help here some. And this is just that interference gold looks white. It's not. Okay. So I wanted red and then black. Should not have put the red on already. Might regret that because I am so slow on this part. He's definitely going to end up on the paint because they always do. Trying to wipe all that off here so I have a clean swipe. How come all of my dirty paper towels always have wet paint on them? No matter when I used it last, always has wet paint. Moving the black around on the spatula. Paint promise I'm not gonna go crazy with the spoon. I promise. I know you guys are used to me going absolutely bonkers when it comes to like the after touch-ups. I'm just trying to give this something to roll over that is wet, because I decided to take the design all the way to the edge, which I might end up regretting. Hopefully not. Just want to give it some space to move. A little bit more up at this top corner here. Is that good as far as where the paint is on the design? Oh, I am shaking today. I think it's caffeine. Right? Moment of truth, people. This is only a 10 by 20, but the fact that it's a gesso board, it is heavy. I got a little chunk there. Ew. I don't know why I'm always tilting away from the camera. It's a bad habit. Get up there! Alright. You don't want to be nice to me? You don't want to be nice to me. Alright, come on. I'm shaking hard. Woo! Come on. It's coming slow, and then it'll be coming in like a freight train. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Right. One last corner. Let's see if I can get you back over here. I lied. I've got two corners. Oops. I got my hand underneath here on the smooth underneath. I'm like, that's not a good idea. A lot of that middle design there. I'm shaking so hard. Why am I shaking? I am amped for this video. Come on. I don't want to lose all that. I don't want to lose all that. Okay. just embracing the fact that there's paint everywhere. Try to get this design a little bit back. So I got it tilted nice. Put you back over here. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm tilting away from you. Here, I'll bring it to you. I'm about to spin, but I want to not be losing all of this pretty. So I'm trying to get some of the heft over. That's centered width-wise. Okay. Gently. This is really pretty. And I have so much paint on me. My whole arm. I have a single spot on myself that I can stop the I think I have this set up to accommodate the 20x20, but I don't remember, so.